welcome to Andrews and to the Conahita Valley. For the next few minutes, you will be looking at a town situated in the largest and most beautiful valley in southwestern North Carolina. A town that still shows its predominantly Anglo-Saxon heritage, with its friendly and industrious people firmly rooted to the land, staking out their own parcels from the valley floor to the hills and coves beyond. You will also see a town that has, for the last decade or so, systematically built an environment to appeal to industry. Largely new is the 64 Acute Bed Hospital, a modern facility in every respect. Nearby is a 50-unit public housing project for the low-income. Just a few years ago, the town's sewer system was renovated, complete with an updated sewage treatment plant, and a new water improvements project having an estimated cost of $2.4 million will be undertaken next year. Further new building has included a post office federal building, total modernization of the town hall, and a community facilities building. The attractive rescue squad facility, which houses the Valley Town Rural Fire Department, sits just off the high school campus, with its recent addition of new junior high and kindergarten buildings. Meanwhile, at the old location on Main Street, construction is underway on a new public library. One of the most ambitious projects is the Recreation Park, a $500,000 complex with something for everyone. It has mushroomed overnight into a focal point for the young and for the young at heart. And last, but not the least important, is the Andrews Murphy Airport. Last year, the runway of this 24-hour facility was extended to 5,000 feet, making it the only airport in a 90-mile radius capable of handling almost any executive jet flying today. District Memorial Hospital is one of the most modern hospitals in southwestern North Carolina. A new wing was added to the facility in 1970 with supporting areas and equipment designed to serve two additional floors. Present bed capacity is 64. Management of the hospital was assumed by a hospital management group in February of 1979. Their assignment is to effect more streamlined operating procedures and rigid cost control to better cope with an inflationary economy and with stringent new federal regulations. In order to maintain the high level of patient care for which the hospital has been known, numerous sophisticated new pieces of equipment have been acquired during the past 2 years. A highly versatile new X-ray became operational in July of 1979. An active recruitment program is underway to augment the present medical staff of 12 doctors. Particular emphasis is being placed on acquiring doctors in the fields of family practice, surgery, and internal medicine. In a park-like setting adjacent to the hospital property on Whitaker Street, the Andrews Housing Authority operates 50 units of federal low-income rental housing. The project provides low-rent apartments ranging in size from 1 to 4 bedrooms. At present, the residents are equally divided between regular families and elderly tenants, with most of the elderly accommodations separated from family units. Currently, applications are predominantly elderly. The authority plans an additional 30 new units for the elderly and for the handicapped when conventional financing becomes available. The Andrews Murphy Airport has proved to be one of the most valuable assets available to industry in the area. Corporate aircraft account for more than 3/4 of the flight operations at the airport. The service area is within a 30 to 40 mile radius of the field, which is located 1 1/2 miles west of Andrews on US 19-129. The runway was extended in 1979 to a length of 5,000 feet. This makes Andrews Murphy the only airport within a 90-mile radius with true jet capability. It will now handle safely almost any corporate jet flying today. This 24-hour facility offers fuel, operational level maintenance, storage and flight instruction. Charter service is also available for connections with major airlines in Atlanta, Chattanooga, Knoxville, and Asheville. Due to the increased use of the airport by executive jets, it is anticipated that jet fuel will soon be made available. Around the airport, there are numerous potential industrial sites, as this area has some of the most favorable topography within Cherokee County. Andrews operates a new recreation park that could well be the envy of any small town in North Carolina. The park is situated on a 10-acre tract on Highway 19-129 on the west side of town and provides something for everyone, from children to senior citizens. The park complex represents an investment of over $500,000. It includes a community center with auditorium, office, private meeting room, and a kitchen. A spacious parking area separates this building from a bathhouse fronting on an Olympic-sized swimming pool. Other facilities include lighted tennis courts, all-purpose courts, and a softball field. A picnic area, shuffleboard court, horseshoe pits, and kiddie playground equipment are provided, and a little league field was added for 1979. The park is served by a full-time recreation director and employs 25 persons during the peak summer season. A score of teams at all sports are fielded for both young and adults, and competition meets are staged with neighboring towns. Numerous activities for senior citizens are scheduled the year around. The center is also the home of the Community Youth Players, a group of aspiring young actors. The Andrews school system is unique in several respects. This is true in the areas of curriculum, sports, and higher education. With a total enrollment of 1,400, of which 600 are in junior and senior high, the high school offers four different curricular tracks, whereas most schools of this size offer only one. This is especially helpful to the student oriented to higher education. A very healthy 64% of graduates move into higher education, compared to the state average of 30%. Of this number, a whopping 98.6% receive scholarships or financial assistance through the unrelenting efforts of student counselors. In fact, in 1978, Andrews was number three in the state at the amount of scholarship money awarded. It is also interesting to note that this year, Andrews is number one in the state in placement of students in summer jobs. Most schools of this size do not have a program for the gifted, talented, or the exceptional student. Andrews does. Most schools of this size have only two or three intramural sports. Andrews now has eight. The school also offers band, art, and chorus, a trio not usually found available in small enrollments. The number of teachers with master's degrees continues to climb, and the school is offering an on-campus master's program under the auspices of Western Carolina University. Here you see an example of a white-collar, middle-class home located in the Andrews area. This home is typical of the residences occupied by the blue-collar workers within the Andrews Labor Resource Area. Additionally, the Andrews area has many both old and modern middle-class homes that reflect its past history and present-day modern living. Andrews is fortunate indeed for a town of its size in respect to the availability of banking services. The town has two banks, Northwestern and Wachovia, both of which offer full banking services. In 1976, this new shopping center, located within the town's corporate limits, was completed. The facility represents a sizable private investment and has contributed significantly to the availability of goods and services within the area. Here, you see one of the important components of the previously mentioned shopping center, the Happy Flounder Seafood Restaurant. There is one Catholic, and there are nine Protestant churches within the corporate limits of Andrews. Here you see the Methodist and a portion of the First Baptist churches. Andrews is proud of its three principal industrial employers, Baker Furniture, the H.D. Lee Company, and O&B Manufacturing. Together, these industries presently employ approximately 525 persons. Here you see Baker Furniture and the H.D. Lee Company, Andrews' newest industry. Approximately 15 miles southeast of Andrews is Tri-County Community College. This facility has both vocational and college-level academic curriculum. Presently, you can see the facility is expanding in order to better serve the needs of its three-county service area. In 1975, the town completed this community facilities building at a cost of $163,000. As you will note, this is the building we are in today. Andrews is somewhat unique among small towns in that it probably has the best facilities base of a town of comparable size within North Carolina. Here you see the town's town hall, renovated in 1975 at a cost of $100,000. Andrews and the surrounding area of Cherokee County are quite proud of the excellent fire and rescue services that are provided by the Valley Town Fire Department and the Andrews Rescue Squad. Here you see their joint occupancy facility. Presently, Andrews has a new public library under construction. The facility will cost $257,000 and has a beneficial occupancy date of December of this year. Gentlemen, as you leave Andrews and the beautiful Conahita Valley, you will be traveling over a newly completed portion of Appalachian Corridor K, a four-lane highway designed to link this area with Interstate 40 to the east and with Interstate 75 west at Cleveland, Tennessee.